Apple's WWDC 2016 keynote is over, and a whole hour of the thing was dedicated to the launch of iOS 10. And if you can't be buggered to sit through that, and we wouldn't blame you, then don't worry, we're going to sum up all of the big new features right here. Warning, if you don't like emojis, then get ready to shit out your guts in pure rage. Lock screen updates in iOS 10. When you raise your wrist, iOS 10 will automatically wake your iPhone, so you can see any wait notifications without actually bothering to unlock it. These will actually be interactive too, so you can 3D touch a calendar invite, for instance, to accept it right there, or respond to any waiting messages. Presumably this will be an optional feature, of course, as most people likely won't want strangers accessing their messages if they accidentally lose their iPhone. Even better, the lock screen also supports third-party apps like Uber in iOS 10, which will offer live status updates. And that's not all, kiddies. A quick swipe left will open up the camera app for easy access, while a swipe right brings up your widgets. Siri updates in iOS 10. Excitingly, Siri is now being opened up to developers, which means that you'll be able to issue commands to third-party apps. That's especially handy if you're lying outside your favorite pub and your fingers refuse to push the right buttons to call you an Uber. Photos updates in iOS 10. With iOS 10, Apple's Photos apps is now basically an offline version of Google Photos, in terms of its layout and its search functionality. For instance, the new location feature means that you can see your photos displayed on a nice little map, making it much easier to skim through any snaps taken on your hauls. There's also facial recognition to find specific people, as well as object recognition, so you can easily find all of those pictures of your family members riding horses. And Apple's new Memories feature collects related pics and videos and beams them at your face as a cheesy slideshow, complete with your choice of background music. Maps updates in iOS 10. Maps has also had a bit of a facelift with a new navigation feature that works a lot like Google Maps' navigation. With Dynamic View, you can see traffic conditions on the map in the form of coloured roads. Red means bad times ahead, as well as petrol stations and any services that are coming up. Oh, and Maps also supports good old Uber now. Are you starting to see a theme yet? Apple Music updates in iOS 10. With 15 million paid subscribers now on board, Apple is making damn sure that it improves the Music app in iOS 10 too. This redesign offers up a fresh new homepage, emphasizing features that you'll use every day, while also helping to connect you with your favorite artists. Apple News updates in iOS 10. Presumably some people out there actually use the News app, which packs headlines from 2,000 different sites into one delicious topical lolly for your enjoyment. In iOS 10, News will now recommend topics based on what you've already read in the past, as well as offering up featured stories handpicked by Apple's in-house editors. And if you actually pay for news, like a proper chump, then the new subscriptions feature will allow you to access your favorite papers and mags, such as the Wall Street Journal and National Geo. Breaking news notifications will also be delivered straight to your lock screen, so you can stay in the loop in super lazy fashion. Get in. HomeKit updates in iOS 10. Apple introduced its new Home app at the iOS 10 launch too, which will be your new go-to place to access all of your home accessories. The Scenes feature is definitely the best bit. Tap the Good Morning scene, for instance, and your connected curtains will flip open and your coffee machine will start brewing. We definitely can't wait to set up our sexy time scene to get the bed rotating and turn on a nice bit of Barry. Phone updates in iOS 10. Voicemail transcriptions is definitely the biggest new feature for the Phone app, which will save you from calling your mailbox every time some PPI selling toss piece decides to give you a ring. And there'll also be some proper caller ID at last, so you'll know when to ignore those spammy gits. Messages in iOS 10. Loads of changes here. For instance, YouTube video links that people send you will actually play out inside the app. However, the big whoop is that the emoji feature has been overhauled. Yay. Emoji predictions will now pop up as you type, and once you've actually finished a message, you can go back and replace any given words with emoji to make them even more annoying. Meanwhile, the bubble effects feature animates your message. So for instance, something like congratulations can explode onto the screen to really get those pure emotions across. And the full screen effects feature is similar, allowing you to turn the background into animations like a fireworks display. Great news for any epileptics out there. Apple's QuickType keyboard has also been polished with a bit of Siri-style intelligence. So for instance, when you're chatting with your bestie, Siri will now be able to offer up your GPS location if someone asks where you are, and can also automatically fill out a calendar event based on a conversation you've just had. And multilingual typing is also now supported, so you can switch languages on the fly without fiddling around in the settings. Random iOS 10 updates. Apple also announced quite a few random little features that will also be hitting iOS 10. So for instance, you can now clear all current notifications with just a quick tap. Ah, sweet relief. You also now get a new music section in the command center, which gives you full album art and track info, as well as in-depth controls. The new split view mode in Safari allows you to put two websites side by side on your iPad, and also 3D touch is slowly becoming a lot less pointless with proper support. So for instance, Apple showed off the new ESPN app, which offers live score updates and even video feeds when 3D pressed. But most excitingly, it looks like we might finally be able to remove Apple's own brand apps from our desktops. Yes! Bye bye stocks, don't let the door hit your arse on the way out. And to finish our iOS 10 feature roundup, here's that awesome bit where Apple tried to get an audience of gawky white boys to rap along with the Sugar Hill Gang. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more iOS 10 action.
Come on, y'all! Okay, you know what? No. We are gonna pause this, okay? Because some of you guys are not rapping to the beat, okay?